Good morning, dear children. Today we shall start the next chapter, lesson 22, vocabulary. There are different types of words in all languages. Some are similar in meaning, some are different in meaning, some of them are having the similar words with different spellings and with different meanings. Today we shall discuss all these different kinds of words in English language. First of all, we are going to discuss about synonyms. Synonyms. Synonyms are different words or phrases in a language that have a similar meaning. Synonyms are the words having the similar meaning. Similar meaning or the same meaning. Words which are having the same meaning are called synonyms. For example, elephants are bigger than mice. Elephants are bigger than mice. Elephants are larger than mice. Now here there are two words, bigger and larger. These both the words are having the same meaning. So these kind of words are called synonyms. Now let's see other examples. Answer or reply. Answer and reply are the words having the same meaning. Clear? Answering someone, replying someone. Bright or shining. Now see, the different words having the similar meaning, the same meaning. So these are also the synonyms. Fast, quick. You can see here the different words with the same meaning. So dear children, these kind of words in English are known as synonyms. Synonyms means the different words having the similar meaning or the same meaning. Now let's see the second term. The other kind of words are antonyms. Antonyms. Clear? Antonyms are the words with different meanings. Clear? The words which are having the opposite meaning. Clear? Not the similar meaning, but the opposite meaning. Clear? These kind of words are called antonyms. Words with opposite meaning. Words with opposite meaning are called antonyms. For example, old, its opposite is new. Clear? Tall, short, its opposite is short. Clear? Full, empty. So you can see here, old, opposite word is new, tall, short, full, empty. So all these are the antonyms. Words which are having the opposite meanings are known as antonyms. Now the last is homophones. Homophones. Homophone word is made up of two words, homo and phones. Clear? Homo and phone. Homo means same, phone means sound. Clear? Homo means same, phone means sound. So words which are having the same sound, the similar sound. Clear? But their spellings are different and their meanings are completely different. Sometimes their spellings may be same, but their meanings will be different. They are pronounced in a similar way, in a same way. The pronunciation, two different words, their pronunciation can be same, but their spellings and their meanings will be different. These kind of words are known as homophones. Let me write here the example. For example, write, write, righht, right. When I pronounce this word, I say right. Again, this is right. Spellings are different. write, right. right, right. This right means, which is, write, right means writing something. I am writing on the board. Clear? And right, right means correct, which is correct. Clear? So both the words are having the different spellings, different meanings, but their pronunciations are same. So these kind of words are known as homophones. Clear? Let me write another example. K-N-O-W, no. These two words, no. Exactly same pronunciation, but their spellings are different. K-N-O-W, no. K-N-O-W, no means knowing something. Clear? N-O-No means denying something. So, different spellings, different meanings, but the same pronunciation is known as homophones. Clear? So, here in this chapter, we have studied about three terms, synonyms, antonyms, and homophones. Synonyms means words having the similar meaning. Antonyms means words having the opposite meanings. Homophones means words having the same pronunciation with different spellings and different meanings. So, I hope all these three terms are clear to you. Thank you.